Need a new gloss.
I got some shine right here.
Gotta last like a boss.
I'm trying all the long way.
This lipstick has been so very dry.
These are so smooth, you're gonna die.
Hello everyone, and welcome to the lips portion of the Emily Awards, one of the categories I am personally most enthusiastic about. This past year offered so many new lip products. I really took a renewed interest in gloss, and that definitely carried throughout and caused me to try a lot of different things. I've grouped all my favorites together in a little bucket down here, so let's get going. The first category is cream lipstick. So we're gonna have a matte lipstick category too. So by creamy, I'm meaning kind of a traditional formula that really glides on the lips, might offer some shine, just has that real buttery, smooth, classic lipstick quality to it. And my drugstore winner, can't be a surprise here, is the L'Oreal Color Reshine. And this is their first time winning because it was within this past year that they kind of became a thing. And I absolutely love this texture so much. The packaging is also fantastic here. Can we just appreciate that nice kind of plastic yet kind of crystallized looking tube? And then on the inside, it's also great how your stick has that little tube coming up closely against it because it is a softer formula, very rich and creamy, and it's kind of like lip gloss and lipstick rolled into one. It's kind of its own special breed of shiny lipstick. And these are a cream lipstick, I think, in the truest sense because they're not shimmery. There's not little particles in there. They're just very, very smooth, and when you put them on, you get an instantaneous shine and very full color right off the bat. So a couple favorite shades for me would be the Burnished Blush shade, which is a really nice, I think, wearable pink. We're not talking Dusty Rose with that one. That's a true pink. And then a great, like, every person's color here would be Varnished Rosewood. Mauvey, deeper, your lips but better. I've worn this shade so much, the top of my lipstick is looking a little rough right now, but I love that color. It's kind of plummy, too. My high-end pick is not new at all. Bite has won this category for quite a few years, and I think for good reason. Even though over the course of the Emily Awards, they have gone from being called Luminous Cream Lipsticks to Amuse Bouche Lipsticks, they are a fantastic product, and I'm holding my set here because I just noticed this is marked down to 15 bucks on Sephora's website. That is a steal for this. I think 25 bucks, the original price, is a steal for this, but you're getting four minis. I'll link below to the video where I try them all on for you, but I just love the formula. It's creamy. It's not going to offer as much shine as the L'Oreal ones do, but you notice a little kind of healthy, natural sheen when they're freshly applied, but there's a luxurious feel to these. I own one Tom Ford lipstick, and I feel like these actually are kind of similar to that. And just the really luxurious glide and little bit of thickness that comes across the lips. So many shades to choose from. In terms of that little kit, I've actually been using the color Saki quite a bit, which is a really nice dusty mauve. Sort of a unique shade once you see it on the lips. It's kind of unlike a lot of different colors that I have, but it's an absolutely wonderful texture. And for 15 bucks to get this kit and experiment with a few different shades, it's just amazing. Now when it comes to matte lipsticks, we have a new drugstore favorite. It's actually the Demi Matte formula of these CoverGirl lipsticks. I think they're called Exhibitionist lipsticks. And they do make creams and they have metallics, but I think the Demi Matte is kind of the most impressive thing to be able to find. You know, that matte formula that doesn't feel overly drying, really full color in one swipe, and just a very strong color selection too. There are several shades that are great. Streaker is an awesome nude. I love this color called Worthy. I was wearing this in the last Emily Awards video. Interesting thing about Worthy is with one swipe across the lips, like more of the pink in this red shows, but then two swipes and it looks like the most full-on classic red you've ever seen. Also enjoy this shade called Trending, which is kind of like a little bit taupey, neutral, sort of one of those 90s colors. But I love the shades, I love the feel, and the staying power has been like all day with this stuff. So that's really impressive out of a classic style lipstick. Now for high end, the product I'm gonna categorize here doesn't necessarily market itself as a matte lipstick, but for the bulk of their formula, that's kind of what it turns out to be. And I'm talking about Besame. And this brand knows how to do lipstick. You wanna talk about staying power from a single lipstick. I mean, they promote this sort of double blotting technique where you apply the product. They do recommend using a lip brush with these, but you put it on, you blot it off, you apply it again, you blot one more time, and that stuff is locked in. And they really major in reds. This is a brand that pulls in these iconic colors, samples of them from all throughout makeup history, and then they recreate them and make them something in a modern formula that you can wear. And I love the the shape of the stick, the little points on each side. This shade is Red Hot Red. This has been a longtime favorite of mine. It's actually Marilyn Monroe's signature shade. Now, new this year, they've put out a creamier formula. They call it House of Besame. They're packaged in cute little pink tubes, and I like those, but I still think what's most special about the brand is their main line of lipstick, and some you will find are a little more matte than others. Some are a little more creamy, but ultimately, with wear, they all get to that matte place. For example, their Red Velvet shade you might find to be just a little creamier than Red Hot Red. There might be subtle texture differences, and they don't flat out market these as matte lipsticks, but it's just the inevitable experience that you get from wearing one, and they're still not drying. They're incredibly long wearing. For a lot of practical reasons, I like these, but also there's just a certain kind of style that this brand has that I love so much. It makes you feel glamorous putting it on, and I enjoy what they stand for in keeping classic shades alive in our makeup using world. For jumbo lip pencils, there's a certain drugstore product that has been kind of in charge of this category for years, and I mean, that's not to say it couldn't be dethroned sometime. I'm always looking out for good stuff, but I've yet to see anything better than the Neutrogena Moisture Smooth Color Sticks. Affectionately named the sweatpants of lip colors, they are a product that can do that intense one swipe color, but actually feel balmy. There's a balmy thickness. If you are dealing with chapped lips and you still want to wear color on your lips, this is the best thing I could recommend to you. Over the years, they've expanded their color range. At first, it was like a small handful of shades. Everything had shimmer. Now they've put in richer shades, more just straight up creamy shades. But whatever you pick from that line, you're going to find an intense level of moisture with it. They're just a can't miss product. I love the rich raisin shade. I like this because, I don't know, with a lot of tinted lip balm or treatment-oriented lip products, your shades are gonna go lighter. They just tend to be put out in more subtle tones. And this one's pretty rich, but you can still sit back and be like, hey, nobody knows I'm getting like great nourishment here for my lips. This product is amazing. For my high-end jumbo lip pencil, I've got something kind of unique here in terms of the formula. It's a really interesting product that kind of melts down on the lips. And it's from Marc Jacobs, and it's called the Le Marc Liquid Lip Crayon. I'm holding it here in the shade Send Nudes, which I think is one of the best, most wearable colors. It's like ultra dusty rose. This color happens to have like a teeny bit of satiny sheen, but it's the most interesting sensation when you put one of these on because you feel like it would just be a straight up lipstick or lip crayon type texture, but it melts down and it's kind of thin, and yet it's very long wearing. They wear very evenly. I'll have to link below to the video where I talk more about these products. They're so fun and so interesting, but they're something I sometimes forget about because it's like it's in its own unique little lane here where, yes, it's kind of like a lipstick, but it's also super thin. They do give me a good amount of moisture, nowhere in the ballpark of the Neutrogena, but you know, they feel nice on the lips. And also they've got a cap that gives you an added snap shut to, I guess, preserve that quality that it has of being this almost cream to liquid feel on the lips. It's really cool. And now in the category of lip products that most frequently lets me down, liquid lipsticks. I feel like so much of what I try ends up being too dry, sucks the life out of my lips, feels like some sort of shrink wrap on my lips. Like, why is this appealing to anyone? Sometimes I come away feeling like that. But there are some brands doing it right. And from the drugstore, I've got to give it up once again to the Superstay Matte Inks from Maybelline. These are some of the longest wearing lip products you will find. You will be actually actively removing them from your lips at the end of the day. Anytime I'm wearing these, that's what I do. I've got a couple shades here that I think are awesome. I love Lover, which might best be described as like deep pink. It's really wearable pink. I love that. And then Pioneer is this beautiful red. Red is a great color to have in this formula because you don't want it going anywhere, and this will really stay put. That being said, they are matte. If you came for buttery smoothness, you gotta look to some of my other categories because these aren't that. I can wear them all day and not feel overly parched, and they're overall just not as drying as a lot of the liquid lipsticks out there, but they wear truly like none other. Now, I must caution you though, if you go layering on balms and glosses on top of this, that's going to practically re-liquefy the lipstick. You got to watch that and just be aware of that. If you're putting anything on top of a liquid lipstick that goes on and sets like these do, you're going to be kind of breaking it down prematurely. So if you really want maximum staying power, wear this and this alone. The only product that's kind of not that way would be the original CoverGirl Outlast that comes with its own special balm. You put it on, it really does help it last. For high end, it's the product I've been wearing all throughout this video. I wanted to make sure I wore it as I was speaking about it because it's kind of hard to describe. And it's from M Cosmetics and it's called the Infinite Lip Cloud. And this shade is called Rose Nude. I'm holding a mini of that here. I was freaking freaking out before this video because I couldn't find it and it was down in my purse. This feels a lot like the Bare Minerals Gin Nude Liquid Lipsticks, which I think are really nice. They're very comfortable, but it's a little more long-wearing than that. It's just as comfortable. It literally makes your lips feel pillowy soft, but the color isn't quite as prone to transferring off the way the Bare Minerals Gin Nude Liquid Lipsticks do. And to look up close at my lips, I mean, yes, they look completely matte. There is no shine there, but they don't look like they've been sucked dry or like just really unhealthy. If the Superstay Matte Ink is something that's 100% like set on your lips, this is probably like a 75% set, you know? When I press my lips together, I still feel moisture between my lips, but yet it still gives me long wear. By that I mean I might make it through a meal and not even feel the need to reapply. It just depends. But I would say the Maybelline for sure is going to get you through all day. This is going to get you through most of the day, but a really comfortable, exceptional formula. M Cosmetics, I mean, they are doing it right. They are releasing very few products in their line. I hope they continue to do more, and I don't mind if they keep it at this slow pace because everything they have made has been such good quality. I've got a category for lip cream. So for this, we're talking about the product that goes on full color, not especially shiny, just not that lacquer kind of reflective quality that a gloss has, but yet it's not in a solid formed lipstick. And the product that defines that to a T is the L'Oreal Infallible Pro Matte Gloss. Big winners last year, love them again this year. I'm holding the shade called Statement Nude, which is a super great basic if you like a little deeper neutral. But what's interesting about these, they're called a Pro Matte Gloss. They are not really shiny on the lips, but they're walking kind of a line there where I could only call them a lip cream. They're so comfortable, so opaque. There are beautiful colors in this line, from the berries to the reds to the nudes like this. I really dig the pointed applicator because you have all the precision you need to get right out to the edge of your lip line but not go over. It's stuff like this that has really eliminated my use for lip liners a lot because they've got applicators that are so good and so precise these days. But I absolutely adore the Infallible Pro Matte Glosses. And then in the latter part of this year, I've discovered something from a high-end brand that is really similar to that. It's from the Balm, and it's called the Balm's Your Creamy Lip Stain. And I think of this as the texture of a gloss going on, but yet once that shine leaves you, which it's not incredibly shiny from the get-go, but once that's gone, you've got a really long-wearing look left behind. So I see that staining effect happening, and I have that here in the shade Hello, which I think is a great berry, but an ultra-comfortable feel on the lips. If I could nickname this category, I think I'd call them, like, comfy glosses, because they don't have that glassy shine and sometimes stickiness that we just automatically associate with a lip gloss, like hair getting stuck in it. They're just a little more soft and casual, you know what I'm saying? Lip balm, let's talk about lip balm. I've got an old classic that I've been using lately quite a bit. And this comes in a couple different formats, a pot or a squeezy tube like this, but it's from Smith's and it's the Rosebud Salve. The packaging itself just screams old school, but if you want a classic balm, it has kind of a pink look to it, and it smells fantastic if you like roses, but it sort of feels like Vaseline going on the lips. It's the kind of thing, actually, that if I were gonna, like, create my own lip color, and I have done this before as I've been playing with glitters and different things, you could swipe this on and then tap a little bit of a loose glitter pigment into it and easily create your own lip shade, because while it has a pinkish look to it, it's not gonna, like, make your lips pink. It's overall just colorless, standard, really classic lip balm, but it's very comforting, and I love the scent. My high-end pick here is something a little bit different. It's very, very unique, and it's from Sarah Happ. It's this product called Plump and Prime. I've never really seen anything do what this product does. It's got a great little applicator there that's a little more, like, bulbous at the tip. I don't really like that word, by the way. But you smooth it on, and it feels velvety, and it kind of, like, fills in all the lines in your lips, and it does make your lips look plumper. I would say I see the biggest effect from this after I have used some kind of lip scrub. You don't have to get the Sarah Happ. You could get a $3 e.l.f. lip exfoliator, and then your lips are, like, juicy and all rosy from the exfoliating process, and then you pop something like this on, and you look so smoothed out and plumped. This also has a little bit of a rosy, slight, very light florally scent to it. And don't think that because Plump is in the name, it's gonna feel stingy or uncomfortable. Not at all. It just makes your lips look fuller and more perfect by filling in all the lines. Okay, tinted lip balms. We've got a couple of winners here. I love a good tinted lip balm, and my Neutrogena Revitalizing Lip Balm takes the top spot again. These are the most simple little tubes, but look at them. They're ovals, and I love that. I want more lip balms in oval shapes, guys. And this is the soft caramel shade. It's very, like, just a touch of nude sort of color, but I keep that Sunny Berry shade in my purse at all times. I like the scent of these. They're a little bit fruity. It's kind of funny. They're not quite as thick going on as those Moisture Smooth Color Sticks that I mentioned earlier. Just a little more lightweight than that, but still very hydrating and definitely the kind of product for a person who's just not interested in wearing a lot of color on their lips, wants something very low fuss. This would be a great thing to go for. Make your pal who falls into that category like a little gift basket of different shades of this. And then my high-end pick is a new thing that I have absolutely fallen in love with this year. And I mentioned how Sephora's got a bite set on sale. Well, they've got this set of the Buxom Powerful Plump Lip Balms on sale too. I think this might be 15 bucks also. Here's the thing, they call these minis. These look every bit like a full-sized lipstick, my friends. I've never seen the full size in person, but it must be huge. I'll also link to the video where I talked about these more in depth and tried them on, but they are a tinted lip balm that's kind of cooling. It's got that classic kind of buxom, minty tingle sort of feel, but actually kind of long wearing. They do sort of a staining thing, and I love this red. This red has really grown on me. It's called Fiery. It's a really nice pop. It gives so much life to the face, and I like the berry shade too. That'd probably be my other favorite is the one called Flushed, and it looks pretty dark in the stick but goes on looking more like just a classic berry. My one complaint as far as the set goes would be that the shade called Glowing, which looks to be very neutral, actually ends up turning sort of a pinky shade on my lips. It's kind of like their color called Big O, which looks a lot like that It Cosmetics Je Ne Sais Quoi, that kind of shade that's going to work with your body's heat and body chemistry and turn into your perfect shade. Well, that's fine and all for that color, but I kind of wanted one shade to be a bit more neutral, and it didn't really turn out to stay that way on my lips. But still, I think the set is a great value. I love the way these feel. They're like a refreshing lip balm. Let's talk about lip liner for a second. I've not been using a lot of lip liner this year. Maybe 2019 will be the year of the liner where I try lots of different eyeliners and lip liners and all kinds of things. But this past year, I just have not been reaching for a lip liner very often. And I do think it comes back to the fact that we've got all these really pigmented wand applicator style lip products that give you all the precision you would need, and they're super opaque, so it's like I'm not sitting here thinking, gosh, I wish I had a lip liner to put under this to really make things stand out or to really define my lips better, because it's not even that necessary sometimes. If there's anything I've reached for, it would be the thing that I do keep handy here on my table. Sometimes I pull it out if I'm doing like a nude gloss look and I'm like, okay, I need a little extra definition around the lips. I might pull for this. It's the Milani Color Statement Lip Liner in Spice. The whole line of Milani Color Statement lip liners is good, and I'm not trying to detract from the good that this can do. It's creamy, it's easy to put on, but so often, maybe some of you agree with this point, there are a lot of products that can do the lining step just because they've got a great, precise applicator. And the final category for lips has been the category that has sort of stolen my heart all over again this past year, and it's the category of lip gloss. And there is a video that I've done, and I think I called it a mini Emily Awards because I really broke down lip gloss into a bunch of different things, and I rewatched that and I looked through the description of everything that was listed, and it's a lot of really great stuff. So if you would prefer to dive into this category a little deeper, I will link to that video below so you can see everything. Because I was breaking stuff down into like best moisturizing gloss, best fully opaque gloss, and all kinds of stuff. But for this video, I'm trying to not do a lot of ties. I'm trying not to give five options. I'm trying to narrow it down to what I think is the best. My drugstore pick is the L'Oreal Infallible Paints line. A shade that has been much loved for me that I'm probably about out of, actually, is Spicy Blush. L'Oreal is kind of doing it right with these glossy type lip products. I mean, I explained the Pro Matte glosses earlier. Well, these have a really comfortable feel. It's going to be one swipe opaque intensity, but more shine than those Pro Matte glosses. And I do like the packaging. It's squeezy tube, but it's got the doe foot, and it's got a little scoop in the doe foot. So it's holding some product, usually enough to get around my whole lips, and I'm not dipping back and forth and back and forth. They make some really interesting shades in this line, some very loud colors if you're into that, but they've got a lot of natural shades too, and if you're looking for a perfect nude gloss, I would say this is it. My high-end favorite has just been waiting in the wings all year to be named in this category, and it is the M Cosmetics True Gloss. M Cosmetics has made 3 Emily Award-winning products this year. Their Brush Tip Liner, the Infinite Lip Cloud in the liquid lipstick category, and now the glosses. But if I had to only pick one thing that they've made as the most outstanding, it would be the True Glosses. They talk about this as being like a gel formula. It is so comfortable, you guys. It is on another level. Putting this on, like all y'all who are sitting there saying, I don't like lip glosses. Have you tried this? Have you honestly tried this? Because this is so pleasing to put on. It's like they've got this odd balance of really hydrating feeling, but it's going to perform and it's going to wear well and it's going to give you that beautiful shine that you expect from a lip gloss. But as you wear it, it does something special. And I've described this a time or two with different products. It becomes one with the lips. It feels less like separate products sitting on your lips and more like a natural smoothness to your own lips. It's not a massive shade range, but it's a pretty varied shade range. And the ones I'm holding here, I love Moroccan Sunset. I've talked about this shade so much. It's a really warm kind of orangey red. I love it. And I also love Secret Blush if you're looking for something softer, more natural, a little bit more neutrally nude. I mean, I'll link to the video where I've tried on everything from this line. That'll give you the best sense of what's happening here. But it is a spectacular formula and so deserving of being an award winner in this category. And again, M Cosmetics, what can I say? I'm not sponsored by them. I have nothing to do with Michelle Phan. I'm simply recognizing these products that I think are on another level. And that, my friends, wraps up the lip video. Whew, what a huge video. I always kind of feel like I'm over a hump when I get through the lip video because there's always so much to say, so many little details. But thank you guys for watching and thank you for your incredible response to this year's Emily Awards. Like, I might cry. I might cry here because I don't know that I've ever witnessed so much support of videos that I've done as I have noticed in this year's Emily Awards. And I can't thank you enough because I do put my heart and soul into this stuff. And when I hear that you guys are like, it's my holiday tradition to watch the Emily Awards or binge on the Emily Awards or watch it with my friends. And I'm just like, oh my gosh, could there be anything better? Thank you so much. And I will see you in my finale coming up next. Bye.